Welcome back to Wasteland 2. We return once again to the house of this guy who left some very strange notes about some special armor. And once again we have the Provost with us, who for some reason is following us around and I have no idea who he is. However, when I loaded in, he would talk to me again. Well, kind of, he would talk at me. I can't have a conversation with him, but he said the weird stuff that he said before. These three things here. For some reason, he won't say them again, but it seems like if you load your game, he'll say them when you click on him. So these kind of look like Latin to me, so I just searched online, I just googled these lines of text, and I did find some stuff. Of course, the first thing was a link to, like, a Wasteland wiki, which I did not look at because, you know, that's no fun to just get all the answers. I'm sure everybody's already solved it already, but I looked a little bit further down and I found out that these lines, at least these first two here, show up on archive.org in some old copyright expired thing they have up there. Something about like the poems of Ovid and Metamorphosis something. I don't know what the hell it is, but these lines of text are contained within it. And when I put them into Google Translate, well, it doesn't seem to detect them as Latin. It tries to translate them in some other language and it doesn't really work. I switched it to Latin and it kind of worked. Like, some of the words made sense, but others did not, and it was just like a word salad. I really couldn't get anything concrete from translating these two things. However, when I translated this last thing, he said, "Homo est devs." That apparently translates, according to Google at least, into "the man is a god." So that's interesting. I don't know who the man is. I don't know if that means literally a man or like the entire human race or something. But, yeah, there's something going on there, and I have no idea what. I'll have links in the description to this archive.org thing and these lines of text, so if you want to do some Googling yourself, then feel free. But what it boils down to is I have no freaking clue what to do with him. He follows me in here, and he doesn't seem to follow me into other places. Although maybe I should test that to see whether that's actually true. There's a book here called The Codex, which, I don't know, I feel like I should be able to translate something with the codex, because the name is suggestive, but I can't seem to. There's obviously something more to this Verchitin armor thing, but I'll be damned if I know what it is. So I guess he's just gonna tag along. Okay, another thing I wanted to do before I take off to go visit the Atchitsons and get their side of the story is I want to go speak to the computer tech guy. I'm trying to remember where the hell he is. God, this map is terrible. It's terrible. Another bunch of arcade machines. Oh, here we go. Because I do have two things that he may be interested in. I have a laser disc, and I also have Aethelwulf's Utopia, which sounds like a book, but apparently it's an old computer. Hey, buddy. Alright, so there's no dialogue options here, but let me try the keywords. Utopia, I guess? No. Laser disc? Alrighty then. Maybe those are items for the Ranger Museum? Or maybe they're nothing, but I thought he'd be interested in them. They're so quaint. Alright. I think it's time to go visit the Atchitsons. I'm looking for something. Nah. Forget it. I don't believe I'm missing anything else here. I think I've visited every place, except I haven't quite been north. Should I go north first? Nah. I'm already south. They're not gonna shoot me, are they? No, I'm not their enemies. I mean, hell, the freaking nomads, the rail nomads, hate me. So if anything, the Atchison should love me. I'm just thinking that all my people are very hurt. They're very, very hurt. I don't think I need to heal them. I kind of just want to wait until I find a doctor. I'm tired of using my med packs. Yeah, I'm just going to go. Mechanical repair can be used to repair any locks. Your clumsy fingers jam. Okay, goodbye. The opposite of a welcome mat. A nice place to visit. The Provost is still coming with us. Okay, maybe the Atchisons will be interested in him. I hear water. Or is that the wind in the trees? If it is, that's very loud wind. Okay, I know the Atchisons like to blow stuff up, so I'm gonna be on the lookout for explosives. I know your tricksies. It's a bomb. Although it looks like it's already disarmed. Whoa! What the fuck? What the fuck? I didn't do it. It wasn't me, I swear. I was just looking. Okay. Well, somebody saved me a lot of time. Or something. Was that the waste wolf I was looking at? Did it decide to just run over there? Oh, shit. Oh, they're freaking out. They're not even dead. I guess those things don't do a lot of damage. Toads and wolves just blew up. Yeah, 17 points of damage. Yeah, they don't do much damage. Whoops. No, no, you can stay. Adorable little doggy. I'm gonna take a risk and not heal my people, because they're gonna level up very soon, which is going to heal them. Oh, shit. Holy shit, there's a lot of those wolves. Never mind. Oh my god. There's like half a dozen. Maybe I should heal my people. Alright, I'm gonna heal my people. Quicker, Theodore, quicker. The wolves. Don't want to have to go Liam Neeson on them. Alright, ooh, okay. Shit. My party is not arranged in the most ideal way. Help me, Provost. Thankfully, they've been softened up. They've been tenderized by various explosives. Alright, she's under pressure. And I'm just gonna move her far away. That's weird. Her gun range is this far, but she can't see that far? I don't understand. Eh, ambush. Oh my god. There's so many wolves. Ooh, an explosive would be really nice right here. They're so grouped together. Okay, well, you're under pressure by a lot. But thankfully, the pressure doesn't seem to stack. Well, wait, maybe it does. Because Helen's got minus 45%? Or maybe it's because she's got a sniper. I don't know, whatever. You have a grenade on you? Do I want to use a grenade? No, I don't. Yeah, 5 AP for the burst. Maybe should have only moved 3 AP worth, not 4, so I could have bursted. Let's go for you. Might be able to kill you. Pretty close. Okay. This is gonna be fun. Looks like these two or these two are my best bet. Let's go with these two. Okay, so the shotgun can hit two at one time. Alright, finally. It's like the first time it's ever happened in the entire game, I feel like. This is like the only time her shotgun has actually been a good thing. All the other times I've gone like, I've just wished she didn't have a shotgun. Alright, we're doing good. Yeah, everybody's gonna get a plenty of turns before this last waste wolf tries to attack us. It'll be dead by then. No problem. Zombie Provost. Nice. Ah, so close to a level up. Okay, I'm thinking I should maybe look out for explosives. I'm not sure what would make me think explosives might be a thing. Yeah, I don't know if it's the fact that the Atchinsons like explosives and even put an explosive on a bike next to a swing. Wait. Swing. Bike next to a swing. Engineer's note. Swing, gun, dig. There's a tire swing there, right? Yeah. Maybe that's the swing. God, I hope I don't forget that. Wait a minute. No. I was just thinking I could add notes to quests, but it isn't actually a quest. Actually, it'd be cool if there was like an open note system. I'll remember. No problem. Now, somebody was telling me there used to be a bug where you could hover your demolition skill over something that was trapped, and it would tell you whether it was trapped or not by giving you a percent chance. Even if you didn't have the perception skill to actually tell whether there's a trap. Which isn't something I want to abuse, but I'm curious if that bug is still there, because it's kind of funny. So let's see. Nothing showed up when I hovered demolition over it. Let's see if it is trapped, which I strongly suspect it is. Oh no, it's not. We shall see soon. Alright, I'm sure there's more explosives. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. It's a gold mine of XP. Let's get everybody away, just in case he critically fails. You know, if I just start shooting at the toad, I suppose it's gonna set off the explosives, isn't it? Let's give it a shot. No pun intended. Oh shit, it's probably gonna die in one shot. Goodbye. Oh. Oh god! Oh, thank god. He was about to run across the explosives. Calm down, dude. Forgot about you. Oh god, my dog might go across the explosives too. This was a terrible idea. Oh god. Damn it, it's out of range. No! Don't die! Okay, it's not going for it. Not going for the Provost, thank god. Shit, I hope he doesn't think I'm an enemy. Nice. Ah, there we go. The Vulture's Cry leveled up. Cool, cool. So he doesn't hate me, does he? Seems like he's still cool. I want to take him with me for the entire game if I can. Ooh, Yulia leveled up too. Excuse me, Vargas.
Copy, Echo One. Congratulations.
Thank you. Only 2 skill points. Energy weapons? Haven't had to use them yet. Plus 5% base chance to hit. That's not very good. It's either that or save up for better demolitions. I'm gonna save. What about you? Safe cracking? Yes. Ooh, pipe bomb. Is at the end of the explosion belt. Actually, we should probably heal the Provost. He might get die very easily. Here you go, buddy. Rail thieves. Damn, they have good vision. Did you just do 30 damage with a pistol? Holy shit. Surprised that his rotting wheel gun didn't blow his hand off. Rail Thief Pistolier hits Theodore Flint, doing 30 points of damage. I think that was a crit. I guess I'll move here and try to shoot past the Provost's shoulder. Please don't hit him. These dudes actually have a lot of health. Yeah, I need to heal my people before I keep fighting them. Lots of friendly fire opportunities here. Not a good thing. Let's get the gun wielders first. Which means I need to move first. I think I'm gonna burst. Oh shit, the hide advantage, right. That's why it's so hard to hit them. Maybe I don't want to burst, because if I burst, I have less of a chance to hit. It's not that big of a difference, though. 15%. I'll take it. Yeah! Don't hit Theodore. Thank God. Don't hit Theodore. Thank God. Is my shotgun long enough to hit both of these people? Maybe. If I focus on you, you're definitely not dead. If I focus on you, you're definitely not dead either. Because if I move and then shoot, then I can only shoot once. Spread out a little bit. See if I can reach the other guy. Yes, I can. Oh, there's another one. Oh god. Yeah, I think we might have to revive a couple people. Minus 20% she has to hit. Shit. Alright, Theodore's close to dead. I should perhaps move him into cover. And into higher ground. That would probably be wise. Hopefully there's not like a cache of a million enemies over here. No, we're good. Yeah, we're at a severe height disadvantage. We kind of just need to get up. Moving here wouldn't be great. Then again, Vulture's Cry has fine health. Yeah, let's move. Her health is fine. She can take a hit. Good try. Don't you fucking shoot the Provost. He's under my protection. I'm his protectorate. Oh, I'm still on burst. Okay, that makes things better. Now, I should probably start moving you. She actually doesn't have that much health herself. Shit. I don't want to move so close that I get maybe more enemies after me. I kind of want to move her here, but then this dude's going to move and just shoot her. What does he have? Yeah, he's got an assault rifle. Go up here. Oh shit, there's another enemy, no! Oh god, I knew there would be. Fuck, we just need to move our people up here. Gonna spend this whole turn just moving. I don't want to take cover on the fucking opposite side of this thing. Yeah, I'll take cover and let you shoot me in the back. Wonderful. Just have to stand out in the open. Fuck me. You don't have that much health either. I can move you here. What the fuck are you wearing? He's wearing like a tutu or something. He's actually rocking it pretty good. I respect your sense of fashion. If I move here, I'm probably going to take shots from two different places. Shit, there's three of them? Where's the third one? Oh, right, you. Fuck. Fuck. Alright. Alright, well, if I move him here, then he can only take hits from one side. Probably from this guy. If I move him here, he could probably take hits from both, maybe? I don't know. It's not great either way. Do I keep softening you up? No, we need to move. Yulia's got plenty of health to spare, so hopefully somebody shoots at her instead of somebody else. Okay, good, you're running away. Excellent. Perfect! Yulia's a meat shield. Don't you fucking hit my dog! Get him, Provost! He actually doesn't do a lot of damage with that melee weapon, so they can probably handle themselves between the dog and the Provost. I'm gonna leave him alone and hope for the best. Although, I could shoot him now that we have such a height advantage. Yeah, I'm gonna burst him. Beautiful. That is powerful. This thing's got such a huge magazine, still got 19 more to go. Alright, what do I do with you? There's really nowhere to take cover. Well, at least you can only take shots from one side. But now these people are too far away from the rest of my people, so... fuck. Alright, well Theodore has to stay in here, he's way too hurt. In fact, just... can you heal yourself during combat? Yes, you can. Why don't you just do that? Alright, I don't think anybody's gonna shoot at you from that far away. I don't even think they can reach you, so you can move out into the open, that's fine. You have a sniper? Wonderful. Yeah, 66% chance is not bad, let's take it. ...68 is even better. Let's move you so you're not shooting over Vulture's Cry's head. Oh. Alright, Harper's got a bit of health to spare. I can't move him into a good place to shoot unless I move him here, which is a little bit dangerous. But if I don't move him, I mean, I'm never gonna be able to shoot them. Like, can I aim specifically at their cover and just blow it up? I don't know why I did that. Whatever. I didn't think that would actually work. But it actually does. You can't actually just click with an assault rifle and just aim somewhere and it shoots. I kind of assumed that only worked with cone-based weapons like this. Now, shotguns, I think, can destroy cover. Let's try it. Maybe only weak cover. Yeah, okay, probably only weak cover. Oh god, don't get shot, dog. Don't get shot! Oh no. Alright, they seem to run away when you get to ow. They seem to run away when you get close to them. They don't like having their cover overtaken. ...41, that is not good. Let's force this bastard to move. He's not gonna shoot me at point blank, I don't think. Yeah, now he's way too far away. Hopefully nobody shoots at her. Ooh, 79%. I guess he's technically not in cover from where I'm at, which is weird, because actually from where I'm at, it looks like I would shoot the edge of this barrel in my line of fire, but I guess it's just right. Yeah, I'll take two shots with that. Alright, this guy's probably gonna run away. I could run up to him and shoot him, or I could try to ambush. Yeah, might as well move up now. Probably gonna flee. Shit, her weapon's empty. Don't shoot dog. Okay, good. Yep, he's fleeing. Just what I thought you would do. So if I could use 3, I could burst him. 4, nah, I can't use 3. Alright, let's move here. Protect me from the other dude while I'm shooting this dude. Nice! Alright, this dude won't be a problem. Please don't shoot, dog. ...40%, that's terrible. See if I can get a good shot here. Now it's even worse. That's ambush. Shit, he's actually gonna get to do something. Cause everybody's gotta like move and reload. Nice. Shot in the back. Ooh. Oh man, I want to move her up here for the height advantage, but there could be enemies inside. Eh, it's not worth it. Should take him out, yep. Whew. A good amount of XP. Some pretty tough enemies. We're really running out of medpacks. Well, I'm not low on medpacks, but I mean, I'm really using a lot of medpacks. A disturbing amount of them. Ooh. It's a fancy looking gun. See what Helen thinks of that. Probably not better than the melee weapon we already have. Oh shit, she's overburdened. Nice. I mean, I'm assuming once you get to higher level territory, you're probably going to start finding med packs that are just always bigger. Like, you'll probably stop finding the pocket medic pack and start finding the medic pack and then, you know, up and up and up to the higher level area, so it's probably not going to be that big of a deal. Alright, I need to lighten her load. Oh right, she doesn't even really use melee weapons anymore. I've got her with a pulse rifle. Which, for some reason, is unloaded? Why? Anyway. Yeah, the mangler's pretty fucking heavy. Wait. She's not overloaded anymore? Her weight's 86 out of 117. I don't get it. What changed? Does ammo not have weight when you load it up into a weapon? 88. 88, load it up. 86. Oh, it doesn't have weight when you load it up into a weapon. Interesting. And apparently, to be overburdened, you don't actually have to be at your weight limit, just, I guess, kind of near it. Let's move some of this heavy shit to somebody else. Theodore, you're lightweight. Actually, no, you're not a lightweight. Oh my god, you're carrying so much stuff. Somebody have another pump shotgun. Here you go. Withered toy. Ooh, that looks cool. Is it any good, though? Let's check. Holiday store supplies. Oh, yeah! That's right, the real nomad thieves stole the supplies from the store. Sweet. We recovered a crate of supplies. Mm-hmm. As Miss Bishop and Mr. Holiday mentioned, has been stolen. Return that to him in a minute. Well, more than a minute. Probably a very long time, actually. I want to finish with this whole Atchits in place before I go back. Alright, compared to the FAMAS. Higher damage. Hit chance is the same. Crit is the same. Crit multiplier is slightly lower. Chance to jam is lower. Range is lower. Capacity is lower. Armor penetration is higher. AP is same for single shot. Higher for burst. I don't really know. Actually, that's kind of... It's pretty close. It doesn't do that much more damage. The slightly higher burst shot cost and AP doesn't really matter. Because if I'm going to be burst shotting, then I'm only going to be able to do it once every turn anyway, whether it's 5 or 6 AP. Armor penetration sounds nice. Capacity doesn't matter, the range does. 4 meters less is a significant reduction. I think it might be marginally better. It does actually cost more. As you can see, the FAMAS is apparently worth 93, and the HK33 is 123, so apparently the game seems to think it's better. It's also lighter. Yeah, let's give that thing a shot. Oh yeah, pistol. Much higher damage, but she can't shoot as much with it. Range is the same, capacity is the same, armor penetration is higher. Unfortunately though, with her AP, that means she can only shoot twice with this revolver, whereas with a Midnight Special she can shoot four times, so I'm gonna stick with the Midnight Special. Ooh, trapped. Nope, just electronic lock, and a normal crate. Yay, a pipe. It's like finding coal in your stockings. Oh no, that's electronic lock, that'd be for Harper. It's a pretty hard one. And his skill at computer science is 3, which actually is kind of low. I should probably upgrade that next. Yeah, I'm gonna upgrade that next time he levels. More faded Polaroids of green lush forests, I'm sure. And some ammo. He needs it the most. Let's give most of it to Angela and a little bit of it to Harper. I'm just gonna call him Helen. Yeah, close enough. Starts with an H. My god, there's so many of these. Tumblr. No mechanical tumblers or wheels accessible from the outside. Its locking mechanism appears to be controlled by a high-tech electronic system. So, computer science? Yeah. Oh no! Harper, what have you done? More laser discs. Alright, see if we can fix that. No? I guess it is mechanical repair, and that's not really mechanical. Shit. Oh well. I could blow it up. I kinda want to. Where's that pipe bomb? Yeah, fuck that thing. Ooh, there was a trap on it. Triggered a trap. Yes, that's exactly what I wanted to do. Switch everybody's weapon, even though I only had him selected. Thank you, game. And now when I had everybody selected, it only swapped his weapon. Oh my god, why have they not fixed this yet? Jesus Christ. Okay. I only have Harper selected, right? When I move, he's the only one selected. I'm gonna swap his weapon. Okay. Press space. Everybody's now selected. I'm gonna swap everybody's weapon. Okay, thank you. You're kidding me, right? I must have blown up the good shit. If this is the only thing in here. Because I think it does destroy the contents if you blow it up. At least, some of them. Oh, can we not actually go in here? Huh. I guess we can't. Well, in that case... Freaking Polaroids. It's creepy. Alright, I was gonna wait to go back to the Rail Nomads camp. But I do want to end the episode soon, but before that, I want to do something before I forget it. And that's the whole swing thing. Also, I suppose while I'm here, I should probably go give the store supplies back to the dude. Wait, that tip in the loading screen just said Animal Whisperer and Computer Science can be used during combat to bring enemies over to your side. I did not know that. Are you an android? I still think you kind of seem like an android. Can I use Computer Science on you? No. Alright, where's the store? I mean, these carts, these rail cars are not exactly very distinctive. That's the bar. Wait, hold on. Oh, I think this is it actually, isn't it? That's the bar. Is this the store? Yes, it is. Okay. We've recovered your stolen supplies. Thank you, Rangers. Look, I don't want you to get the idea that my merchandise is overpriced, but in the interest of supporting our brave and helpful Desert Rangers, I'll give you 50% off. Oh, and I suppose you can have this here book. Ain't never done me no good. The Richard Grieco story. Huh. Thank you. What is this story? Where is this story? It's weird, it didn't show up as new. Maybe I moused over it accidentally and got rid of the new thing. A tale of love, fame, and smooth talking. By and about the real and only breakout star of 21 Jump Street. Plus one kiss ass skill. Alright, that's for Theodore. Kiss has 4, should go up to 5. Nice. Save me some skill points. There's still absolutely nothing I want to buy from him. Explosives are just really expensive. And I don't use them very often. Alright, back to the beginning for the swing. Oh, also, somebody was telling me that you can use the Animal Whisperer skill on this. Which I guess is why the Animal Whisper skill pops up when you mouse over it for some reason. Which is weird. If it pops up when you mouse over it, I don't know why it doesn't just use this appropriate skill. Anyway, apparently I need to whisper to the statue. I don't know. I don't understand how these things work, but sure. Why not? What if you critically fail trying to talk to a statue? What happens? Does it break? Yay! Huh? That's what I got? A rat pops up from behind the statue and starts to follow you. Look at that thing. Oh my god. My animal companions are so beautiful, aren't they? Between this scabby wasteland irradiated rat. And my little doggy friend over here. We've got quite a scary crew. Can I get another one? Nope. Alright, got rats and dogs following us, and an androidic thing. Alright, where is it? Oh, here it is. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. The tire swing looks more like a death trap. A subtle hint of some sort, perhaps? So again, the note says... Swing, gun, dig. Which I'm assuming to mean that at the swing there is a gun, dig to find it. So... this is the only thing that I can actually highlight here. So maybe I just use dig on that? Hmm. No. Wait a minute, what's this? The note reads, sorry Ralphie, couldn't wait around any longer. If a Topekan caught me, I'd be up shit creek. See you tomorrow, Jay. I feel like that's maybe a reference to something. So I can't use dig, huh? Whoops. Hmm. Strange, I really thought this was it. I suppose there might be other swings, or maybe the note doesn't mean what I think it means. Anyway, I'll figure it out later. Or never, ever, ever figure it out. We'll see what happens. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.